Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing certain details about the bifurcations of capital and revenue, expenses and incomes items. There's an illustration mentioned down there and we'll discuss it further. So, when we discuss about capital and revenue items, we have already discussed the types of expenses, incomes, and the various types we've understood further with it. That means the capital item, the revenue item. Revenue item, which is recurring in nature. Capital item, which is once in a nature. Capital, which increases, enhances, reduces the cost of any item. Rather, it also enhances the capacity or profit earning ratio. But on the other hand, revenue is something which is required for the day-to-day process. That means the working should go on. And for the same scenario, we require all these details. So we have a certain illustration mentioned down here, which will help you to understand what kind of items are a part of capital and what kind of items are a part of revenue. It might be income, it might be expense, anything. Let's go ahead and figure out that illustration mentioned down there so that we can understand or have more clarity on the bifurcation here. This is a basic problem, so you won't have any difficulty in understanding. And once you understand this, the advanced one will be a little easy for you to understand the different concepts here. So let's start with the first illustration or the first transaction of this illustration. Purchase of an extra motor van. I'm just reading out this illustration details so that you can figure out or you can start jotting down what would this be, whether this will be a capital, whether this will be a revenue. Make sure before making any conclusion or before reaching to any conclusion, there is certain details available with you. That means whether this will be a one-time usage, whether there is any increase in cost, any additional benefit that is getting, or whether this is a daily purpose work or something that is required for daily purpose. That means if this isn't there, the work will stop or the work won't stop. This is something that you need to understand. So is it an operational activity or something that is adding up to the operational activity? This is what you need to figure out. Second is cost of rebuilding a warehouse wall which had fallen down. Now, warehouse wall had fallen down. You need to figure out or understand whether the cost incurred is a regular cost or a one-time cost here. Building an extension to warehouse. That means whatever warehouse is there, you extend it, you expand it. That's an extension that they're talking about. Painting extension of the warehouse when it was first built. So whenever this extension was first built, you have painted it. That is the detail that you're talking about. Repainting the extension that was done 3 years ago. That means whatever extension, now that in the fourth transaction that you have discussed, that they have discussed or probably they have mentioned that they painted the extension. Repainting that same extension after 3 years is something that we're asking whether it is revenue or whether it is capital in nature. Carriage cost, which is incurred on the new bricks, which were for the extension building. That means whatever extension was getting built, the bricks that were used to make that extension, the carriage cost of that stock is known as capital or revenue is what you have to figure out. Carriage cost and purchase, whichever purchase item that you do in a year, around the year, the carriage cost paid on it, whether it will be capital or revenue is what you have to figure out. Carriage cost on sales. Again, just like purchase, whatever sales you are doing and the carriage cost or the freight cost which is added to it, whether it will be a regular item, whether it will be a one-time item, will depend whether it is a capital or revenue in nature. Legal cost of collecting debts. That means there are certain debts that were supposed to be collected. You have incurred certain legal cost to collect those debts, whether it will be capital or revenue in nature, something that you have to figure out. Legal charges of acquiring new premises for the office. That means new office premises were supposed to be procured and there were certain legal charges that was inputted on that. So you have to figure out whether it is a capital or revenue expense for us. Fire insurance premium. There are certain fire insurance premium that was supposed to be a part of it. Now, whether we have to figure out whether this is a premium amount that is paid regular basis or an annual basis, and depending on that, we'll figure out whether this is a capital expense or a revenue expense. Cost of erecting a new machine. This is the last transaction mentioned in this illustration. There is a new machine for install that machine, or rather to make sure that the installation is functional. We have to incur certain cost. Whether that cost will be capital or revenue is something that we're figuring out. So we have read out all these transactions. We'll prepare a specimen and we'll just note down whether these transactions are capital or revenue in nature. Let's do that. So there are 12 items mentioned here. We'll explain each item to you and figure out whether it is capital or revenue in nature. Let's go with the first one. Now, the first one states purchase of extra motor van. Again, this will be a capital item. Why? We'll discuss. This motor van is an additional motor van that is being purchased. Now, capital is because the reason why capital items or capital expenses being made, they put on add-on value. That means they add to the production cost, or rather they can say that they add up the production. So whatever was being delivered earlier, it might be like 1,000 kilo quantity being sold out with the existing delivery vans. With this delivery van being purchased, we will be able to sell out more. So it is adding up to the revenue, adding up to the income, hence capital in nature. This is one of the trait of the capital nature being a part of it. So this item will be a part of capital nature or capital items being a part of this category. So this transaction, capital nature. Next one was cost of rebuilding a wall of the warehouse which was fallen down. So that means there was a specific wall which was fallen down and you rebuild that wall. This will be a revenue expense. Why? Is because the wall might fall down any point of time. It was never the case that you have built up a new wall there. That means there was never a wall there and you built up certain new wall. It is not that kind of thing. However, this has been stating that there was a wall there. There were certain repairs and maintenance that was done. So repairs and maintenance being a part of revenue expenses, hence this will be a revenue expenditure. Third is building extension to a warehouse. Now, again, warehouse is this much. You are building an extension to it. That means you are creating additional spaces. So that is increasing the capacity. One of the trait again of capital nature transactions. Hence, this transaction will be of capital nature. The next transaction refers to painting the extension walls which was first built. That means this extension which was built, you have painted it. That will be again a capital nature transaction because this is the first time you're building that extension. You're incurring cost into it. So that will be of capital nature here. If in case, again, you're repainting that same thing, that will be of revenue nature because this is something which has been pre-existing and you've been doing it over and over again. So that is of revenue nature and this is of kind of building up in the first time. So repairs and maintenance comes under the revenue part. Had it been this under repairs and maintenance, but this is the first time building, hence it is known as capital nature. Now the next one refers to repainting the extension 3 years later, which was built first as compared in the fourth one. Again, it's repainting, which has been already existing. So that comes under repairs and maintenance. Hence it will be a part of revenue nature. Now, the next one is carriage cost of bricks which are used for extension, the new extension that was built up, the carriage cost of bricks being used for that same thing. So again, that is an additional cost, but that cost relates to a new extension being developed. So that will be a part of the new extension. Hence, it is termed as capital in nature because you're completely building up a new wall here or a new extension here. The next one is carriage cost on purchases. This will be revenue in nature. The reason why is because purchase is your daily operation. It comes in, goes out. Comes in, goes out. This purchase happens on daily basis. Hence, you cannot term it as capital nature because it is your daily operation. Hence, it will be a part of revenue. Next one is carriage cost on sales. Again, just like purchase, this will be again a revenue transaction because sales happens day in, day out. Hence, again, a part of revenue nature. The next one is legal cost of collecting debts. Now, debts or bad debts, anything is a part of business. It happens. It is not that it happens once in a year. It might happen at any point of time, a number of times. Hence, the legal cost in collecting your debts is your official work. It comes under your operation activities itself. That's the reason all these legal charges will be of revenue nature. Now, the next is legal charges for acquiring new office premises. Now, new office premises legal charge is completely different from legal charge of collecting debts. You collect debts every now and then. You don't procure new offices every day. That is not your business. Hence, when you talk about legal charges for procuring new office premises, that will be of capital in nature. Next is fire insurance premium. Again, a premium which is paid every year, every quarter, every half yearly, every monthly, which can pay up. Hence, this transaction is referred to a revenue transaction and not of capital nature, because this is required for your own business and is nothing adding up to the value of it. It's rather an expense itself under the part of revenue and maintenance. The last one is cost of erecting a new machine. That means cost of installing a new machine. No matter if you're building up a new extension, building up a new site, procuring a new site, or installing a new machine, whatever cost you put in that is an additional add-on to it. Hence, this will be a part of capital nature itself. So I hope with this illustration, it was clear to understand what are the types of, or rather the transaction can be classified into capital or revenue nature and how it is done. So depending on all these scenarios, you'll be able to gauge what is the capital expense, what is the revenue expense, what is the capital income, what is the revenue income. According to that, you have to further notify down things. So things that are not recurring, that adds up to the value and reduces the cost, is of capital nature. Things that are recurring, that is required for regulation or regular operational activities, are termed as revenue expenses. I hope this video gave you a lot of clarity on this. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKeeda and keep subscribing to eKeeda.